China's global reach is present in some unusual ways in Ecuador. The country has defaulted on more than $3 billion of foreign debt since 2008. Since then, China has replaced the World Bank and other institutions in funding the country's public works. Nitza Soledad Perez reports.
$7 billion in 2.5 years. That is a Chinese investment in Ecuador, a South American country of 14 million citizens.
With all these investments coming from the People's Republic of China, we are going to have a new energy matrix in Ecuador, and we're talking about a country that for many years did not invest in its energy sources. So as a consequence, we had a really inefficient system.
Chinese investments in Ecuador are divided in two categories, oil and mining and public works. The most eye-catching is a vast hydropower dam being constructed in the Coca River in Ecuador. The project has been in the works for decades, but cash was a problem. With Chinese investment pulled in, President Rafael Correa and his administration are now ecstatic with the progress achieved.
Government here in Quito predicts that the ongoing construction of the hydroelectric dam will generate around 4,000 direct jobs and 15,000 indirect ones. They're also promising that all unskilled positions will go to locals of the Coca area.
The multi-billion dollar loan from China that's helped turn the hydro dam into a reality is to be charged at an interest rate of 6.9%.
No es inversionista, es simplemente contratista.
The Chinese government provided a loan to the Ecuadorian government of almost $2 billion, and with that, they are paying for the dam that the Chinese are also building. At the end of the construction, the company turns over the dam to Ecuador, and China recovers its investment. There is no risk for the Chinese here.
Other Chinese investments include a $1.7 billion copper mining project known as Ecuacorrientes, which will pay 52% of the mine's profits to the state in the form of royalties and taxes. A Chinese embassy official has this to say about China's investments in Ecuador.
We adhere to the principle of shared development. We do not have selfish interests. We came to help promote the socio-economic development of the country and to achieve joint brotherly success with our Ecuadorian partners.
Ecuador will provide China 60,000 barrels of oil per day for the next 6 years. Nitza Soledad Perez, CCTV, Quito, Ecuador.